I'm going to show you the Illustrator Pathfinder tool like you've never seen it before. Unless you happen to be a dev for Adobe, of course, but for the non-developers out there, let's jump into some advanced tricks with this thing. I have here a PNG image, and none of this is vectorized or able to be handled in terms of a vector object. But the Pathfinder can help in interesting ways with this object. Now, as you can see, I've made a black shape with the pen tool earlier. And actually, I could neaten this up a tad, but anyway, I have a shape overlaying this layer, and then some text off to the left. I'm locking down this PNG with Command or Control 2, and then I'm going to place my text in a way that I think is going to work for my design. So as a reminder, I have the text on top of the black shape, and then below that to the PNG. I'm now going to hold down the Alt Option key when clicking Functions in the Pathfinder window. And that's such as the exclude option found here. And nope, I don't actually like that effect. So what about the intersect option? That looks pretty cool actually. And I'm also liking the minus front option as well. Again, remember to hold down the Alt Option keys when you're doing this. But we can go even further than that. And there is something cool about this that you will soon see. Anyway, I can make a freeform gradient on the shape and repeat the same process over a gradient. But yeah, one of the main uses for this is that my text is fully 100% editable. I can rewrite things, change the font, the color, and so on. So yeah, that's the interesting way to use compound paths with the Pathfinder, but what about a problem that I'm sure you've encountered before? I have four black squares, and on top of that, I have this pinky red circle. Now I want to cut this circle into four squares, leaving negative space in the middle. If we select everything, then hit the minus front option, bam, we get this. That's not ideal. Okay, so what if we group the black squares together? Do you think that will work? Command or Control G to group them, bring the shape back over, and nope, denied. The next logical thing to try maybe is to create a compound path from the four squares. So let's go ahead and do that in the Pathfinder panel. Now, when I click the minus one option, nothing seems to happen at all. That's because we need to hold down the Alt Option key like we did before, crucially after we've turned the squares into a compound shape. This is how you cut a shape into multiple objects below using the Pathfinder. Okay, so next, something really cool to remember and to add into your workflow. This is why we use the Alt Option key when using the Pathfinder tool. Yes, these three shapes are in fact united, but I can double click one of the shapes to enter into isolation mode, meaning I can then move things around as I please, scale, recolor, and so on. But also in Illustrator, if I click out of isolation mode, I can still do things to this united object, such as edit the live corners with the direct selection tool, and that is A on your keyboard. The Pathfinder tool is also great for cleaning up a design. But what do I actually mean by that exactly? Well, if I select this object here and quickly press Command or Control K to bring up the preferences, I'm just going to enlarge my anchor points so you guys can see what's going on. Okay, so I have a few unnecessary anchor points on this object. In the Pathfinder options menu, there is an option to clean up redundant points. If you uncheck this, basically turning it off, you will notice that when I click the Pathfinder merge function, nothing happens. However, if I go back and turn that setting on, and then click the merge function, Illustrator removes the redundant anchor points. You can control how precise you want Illustrator to be so that you can keep the original shape intact. Less anchor points are always better as a general rule in Adobe Illustrator. And here's another feature of the Pathfinder tool that designers often do forget about. Say if I go ahead and unite these shapes at the very top, and then I go along with my workflow, I do this, I do that. But then I want to unite the other objects below that as well. Instead of clicking the Pathfinder menu, say if I've just closed it or something like that, I can just press Command or Control 4. This is going to repeat the last operation in the Pathfinder. So yeah, there are some neat things with the Pathfinder in Adobe Illustrator. If you want to learn more about graphic design or AI, just click a video on the screen. And until next time, design your future today. Peace. All I wanna do is kick